Good morning students. This video we are going to see about another problems on Maclay's method. This is the problem. A simple support beam carries a partial UDL of 40 kN per meter at a distance 4 meter of UDL. The total length of the beam is 8 meter. And with this first step to find with the max to find the RA and RB. This is the foremost first step. To find the RA and RB, first we need to taking moment above RB. Taking moment about RB means we need to consider all the loads. Load is RA and another load is downward partial UDL. So RA into the total distance is A to RB distance is 8. So RA into distance 8 minus, because of the downward load, so 40 into, first we need to convert UDL into weight. 40 into 4 is the UDL into weight, which is acting at middle here, the middle of the UDL, and reference to the medial is 3 plus and 2, totally 5, which is equal to 0, because other side of RB we don't have any loads, and with this we can easily find out what is the value of RA. Is nothing but 100 kN. 100 kN is the value of RA. And another again, summation of upward load equal to summation of downward load. What are all the upward loads? RA and RB are upward loads. This is equal to downward load is only UDL, and we need to convert UDL into weight, mean 40 into 4. So already we know what is RA, and when applied we can easily find out what is the value of RB. So with this we can find out RA and B. This is the first step for this problem. Next we need to form the general equation. What is general equation? The general equation is nothing but bending moment equal to EI d square y by dx square. This is a general form. And in this problem, we have two more sections we have. And A, B, and this is C and D. I need to convert the partial UDL into entire UDL. I just add the another 40 kN on downward side. To balance the downward side, I can apply another 40 kN per meter on upward side. With this, you can equate both of them. For better solving this Maclay's method, I can apply this both side 40 kN per meter. This is a basics one. If you have further doubt, I can clarify through Zoom. Okay. And we in this section, we have A to C is a one section. A to C is a one section. And C to D. This is D. C to D is a another section. C to D. And last one. D to B. D to B is another section. And to form the equation, this is nothing but moment. Instead of moment, I can write EI d square y by dx square, which is equal to, what is the value of AC? If the section is lies between A to and C, mean now the distance is x. X is lies between A to and C. I can draw here. This distance is x, and by using this RA and the temporary section is x distance. So RA into x, because our section is lies between A to and C here, and CD. Now our section is passed from C to D. Now the distance is, this is the x distance, because up to this our section is passing. This is the distance of x. Okay, if it is the x mean, what is the value? Hereafter we have our upper load and download load. Upper load is Ra into x, already we have solved. And added point is downward UDL. Value of downward UDL is nothing but 40 kN per meter minus 40 into distance. What is the value of distance? Actual total distance is x from A to this section. Our requirement is C to this small distance. The small distance is nothing but x minus 1, x minus 1. Total x, this is 1, remaining x minus 1. So x minus 1, and now our section is passed from D to B. Our section is passed from D to B. So A to this section is now, A to this section distance is x. Okay. Now this distance x means, already we consider Ra into x, we already solved. And upward load, downward load 40 kN per meter, 40 kN per meter from C to this section, the distance is minus 40, x minus 1, already solved. The newly added load is upward direction. Upward means 40, same problem 40, into our distance is, we need to distance from D to this section, total distance is x. This distance up to A to D is 5. Our requirement is D to this section, total x minus 5, remaining this distance will be get. So x minus 5. Consider this is equation number 1. While integrate the first equation, EI d square y by dx square is converted dy by dx. And Ra, what is the value? Ra, what is the value of Ra? Already we know what is the value of Ra. Is nothing but 100. X is in the one, integrate x is converted into x square by 2. While integrate, we can add one constant c1 and minus 40. X minus integrated x minus 1 by 2, square by 2, and 40 into x minus 5 square by 2. This is equation number 2, because the dy by dx is nothing but slope. And next, EI, while integrate dy by dx, we get y, 100, x square means x cube by 3, already we have 2, so total 6. Plus c1 integrate, c1 into x, another one constant c2 is arrived. And here minus 40, x minus 1, already square mean 3 by 6, plus 40 into x minus 5, 2 mean 3 by 3, already we have 2, totally 6. This is equation number 3. This is actually a to form general equation statement for this problem only. Next, we need to find out what is the value of C1 and C2. We need to find out. While find out the C1 and C2, we can apply boundary condition. What is the boundary condition? We know already. For simply supported beam, initial and final condition, slope is maximum and deflection is zero. The initial deflection is zero and the final deflection. Deflection is nothing but deviate from the neutral position. Here there is no deviation. Here also there is no deviation. It's flow like this. So initial condition, deflection is zero, and final condition, deflection is zero. The apply boundary condition. Initial condition, x tends to 0, y tends to 0, because initial and final, initial condition deflection is 0. In equation number 3, because the third one is, the third equation is deflection equation. And the one more thing, the x tends to 0 mean is lies between A2 and C, because 0 to 1, this is the distance of A to C. So x equal to 0 mean is lies only up to A to C. The up to A to C means, up to A to C means we need not to consider CD and BD. We can take it into this section itself is enough. Okay, this is actually equation EI. Instead of Y, I can apply 0 because answer is 0, is equal to 100. 0 cube divided by 6 plus C1 into 0 plus C2. The answer is C2 equal to 0. In the most of the cases, the value of C2 is 0. Okay, and another boundary condition. Another boundary condition is nothing but the x at B. X at B mean the total distance is 8. The x is to 0 because RB, the deflection also 0. So x tends to 8 meter, y tends to 0. And x tends to 8 mean the section slice between D to B. D to B mean this is the D2B section. Normally we have a left to right approach so that we can consider all the equation, because D2B we need to consider all this equation. Okay, how to consider all the equation? EI, instead of OK, I can apply 0, 100. Instead of X cube, I can write 8 by 6 plus C1 into 8. Instead of C2, I can apply 0. So we need not to consider 40 into 8 minus 1 cube divided by 6 plus 40 into 8 minus 5 cube divided by 6. The only unknown is C2. We consider this, we can easily find out what is the value of C2. The C2 is nothing but minus 583.33. This is the value of C2. Once we find out the C1 and C2, next we need to find out the position of maximum deflection, because the question is asked the maximum deflection. So first we need to find out the position. Next we need to find out the magnitude of maximum deflection. So position of maximum deflection mean where the maximum deflection will occur, the place where the slope tends to 0 in simply supported beam. The slope tends to 0 means what is the slope equation? This is the slope equation. Second one is the slope equation, because it is du by dx. In this equation, the x where the slope tends to 0, the x value we need to find out. In this equation, we don't know what is the value of x, so we need to consider entire equation. We need to consider entire equation. So boundary condition dy by dx tends to 0, the maximum deflection will occur on that position. Apply equation number 2, and equation number 2 is nothing but EI. Instead of dy by dx, I can write 0 and 100 x square by 2, and instead of C1 I can write instead of C1 I can write the value of C1 is nothing but minus 583.33 and minus 40 into x minus 1 the whole square by 2 plus 40 into x minus 3 the whole square by t. Here the entire term will become 0, and this is the one equation, one unknown. Already we discussed in the class how to find out one equation and one unknown by using our calculator in the equation mode. Already we discussed. If you have any doubt in this also, we will discuss the next live meeting. And while solving this using equation mode in calculator, we can get the x value of x is nothing but the value of x is 3.83 meter. The maximum reflection will occur. And next we need to find out the magnitude of maximum reflection. What is the maximum value of maximum reflection? Already we know the general equation. This is a general equation, and x equal to 3.83 means it lies between, this is 0 to 1, this is 1 to 4, because the 3.83 is lies between C to D. So the C to D we can get the maximum deflection. So we can apply the general equation up to CD is enough. We need not consider this equation D to D, because up to this our maximum deflection will occur. Okay, and general equation, we know the general equation. Okay, boundary condition, x tends to 3.83 meter, apply y tends to y max, apply equation number 3. Okay, EI, instead of y I can write y max, which is equal to 100, x mean 3.83, the whole cube by 6, and minus 40 into 3.83 whole cube by 6. That's all. We need to write out the D to B section. Okay. Here also in problem they clearly given what is the value of E and I, and E and I is given as, E value is 2 into 10 to the power of 5. This is the E value, and I is nothing but 4.3 into 10 to the power of 8. And in general, already we know the right side of the equation, all the value is kilonewton meter. Here in right side E value is newton mm, I also mm power 4, E also newton per mm square. For equating the both side, I can write 10 to the power of minus 9. Y max equal to this thing, for 10 to the power of minus 9 mean convert this side, the value newton mm to kilonewton meter basics. For that the entire equation will be same. So finally y max equal to 0.01633 meter, because the only one unknown is y max. Finally we need to find out y max in mm. So into 10 to the power of 3, 10 to the power of 3, and we need find out 16.33 mm. This is the value of maximum deflection, and corresponding x position is 3.83 meter, and this is the final answer. If you have any doubt in the final regard, I will explain to live section on next day. Thank you.